गाइस, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज रिगार्डिंग द फ्लोचार्ट। वी आर स्टिल डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर नंबर 1, टॉपिक फ्लो chart. Yesterday we read that what is flowchart. Flowchart is pictorial representation of a problem, is it? Now today we will discuss few examples of flowchart. See the page number 8. Examples of flow chart. This is our topic. The boys and girls, in a flow chart, input means to get data from some input devices and store in computer memory. Yesterday we already discussed input means some type of data which is taken by a user and then computer will process on it. After processing, we will get the result from our machine and we have the options to display our output or result on a screen or in a printed form. Is it? A data in memory is given some particular name. Keep it in mind. Underline this line. Our data in memory is given some particular place. In memory, particular space will named. Will name space named variables. I am giving you extra knowledge about the starting of flowchart. Variables in memory. Keep it in your mind. Particular space named. Variable. The particular space we reserve for our data by some names. These supposed names are called variables. Okay, aage dekhiyega. We access data with respect to its given name to perform some computation from which results are obtained. The results are stored in computer memory and we print the results on some output devices. Students, we are going to solve a problem with the help of a machine which is called computers. To handle the problem with computers, there are some points to we have to keep in our mind that the computer always use its memory to calculate, to receive. So first of all, it receives the data from the user, then it saves it. After the receiving, it receive and then calculate and then processing on it. Then when it produce a result, when it produces a result, it also save it. After that, then he will send to the output devices, okay, with the help of some command. It has a complete system, complete procedure to find a solution of a problem. Here I am asking the problem is a mathematical problem. Keep it in your mind. every type of a problem. For a computer is a mathematical problem. It should be solved in computers in a mathematical way. Is it? Don't forget my point, boys and girls. I am repeating my words. Every problem in for a computer, it should be solved in a mathematical manner. So programming is also programming is a mathematical way to write the instructions for the computer system. So programmer write the instructions for the CPU in a mathematically way. See the difference, boys and girls. I am talking about the programming. Our whole chapter is discussing the programming, programming solving problems. So I told you that the computer always solve the problem in mathematical way. Every type of data, it has to be converted in a mathematical term. Okay? There is no topic in your book. I want to take your class, but there is no use if you have any. If you have any problem regarding the concepts of this topic, then you can ask to me. Okay? Look at the board and try to understand the what is actual requirement of the computers. Okay? Our problem should be a mathematical problem. Is it? After that, if we write any type of text, if we write any type of text for the computer problem, it should be converted in mathematical problem. In chapter number 2, we will discuss how computer convert the text into numbers. Is it? There is a complete system is available in computer sciences techniques. Okay, how the every type of data should be converted in a mathematically term, in mathematically numbers. Okay? Okay. So, in this case, yesterday I told you the CPU has two basic units, control units and ALU unit. Control unit is the manager of the CPU. Okay? CPU is a 1 square inch disk, chip, sorry. It is 1 square inch disk. It has trillions of circuits in it. Keep it in mind, 1 square inch. So it has, in its inner side, we have two basic units, CU and ALU. CU mean control. Look at the board. I'm discussing the out of the way. For your convenience, for your understanding, suppose it is your input devices unit. It's a basic structure of our computer sciences hardware. G, friends, it is input unit. Is it? It is your CPU. It has two basic units. It is also connected with CU, ALU, and U. Data passed from input devices to first unit is CU. CU accept the data from the input devices. First of all, it send it to the memory unit. Memory unit save it. Memory unit be RAM. ROM. ROM is working as a passive hardware. The current working or efficient word memory is RAM, which always connected with the CPU and help the CPU to work. Keep it in mind, without storing our data, CPU cannot work on it. Input devices send the data to CU. CU accept it. First of all, CU send this data to the MU, any memory unit. There is data stored. After storing, it send it to CU again. Here CU decode the data. Decode means convert the data into this language which a computer can understand easily. Decode the data and send to the ALU. ALU work according to the instruction which are given by the programmer. Work on the data arithmetically means the operations which are regarding to the plus, minus, multiplication, division, etc., etc. These operations are called arithmetical operations. Whereas LU solve the instructions which has decision making instructions, whether a condition is true or false. It deals the true or false statements of the program. After that, after working, it send the process data again to the CU. As CU again work on it, then send it to the memory unit again. Memory unit store it and then again send to the CU. After getting the proper result, CU send the process data, which is called information, to the output devices. Hope you understand that how the internal work of the computer's system. Actually, first of all, input. User send its data or input with the help of input devices like keyboard, mouse, so on. There are a lot of input devices that depend on the data. If there are different types of data, according to the different types of the data, we can see in our market, there are different types of input devices too. So the input unit passes the data to CU. CU first of all, save it. After saving the data, MU send it again to CU. CU decode the data and send it to ALU unit. ALU means arithmetic logical unit. Mathematically, problems are solved there. After solving, the results are ready. Ready results sent to the CU. CU then work on it again, save it. After saving, MU message the CU, and then it send the data, the prepared data, the resulted data to the output devices. This is the main basic working of a computer. That's why in book, examples of flowchart, I am reading this paragraph for you. In a flowchart, basically where our programming, our problem solving working starts from the flowchart. That's why it said that in a flowchart, input means to get data from the input devices and stored in computer memory. How? With the help of CU unit. A data in memory is given some particular name. Here, when the CU store the data in memory unit, which is RAM, random access memory, as you know that RAM has different cells, okay? Contiguous cell system. In it, the memory cells, which one cell is stored for 1 bit. As you know that one character of a data take place is equal to 8 bits. The memory unit constructed by the different cells in the form of rows and columns. Is it? One memory unit is equal to 1 bit. 1 bit means the constructed wire. Suppose it's a wire. The current, when current pass, it saves the current in the form of a bit, a little bit current. Mathematically, we denote it 1. If there is no current, it shows that there is 0. The memory cell unit saves the 0, no current in it, mean. So, 1 and 0 mean 1 bit. 1 mean 1 bit, 0 mean 1 bit. Simultaneously, one wire has a current or not. Not same time, the one wire. It is understood when we start to pass the current in a wire. When we pass the current, it will show 1. We denote by 1. If no, then we denote it by the 0. Is it? 1 and 0 both in a single bit. Okay? So, a memory unit. A character, suppose A is a character. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Computer scientists reserve at least 8 bits for a character. Maximum 8 bits for a single character. Our RAM is constructed these type of the cell units. Every memory cell unit has its own address. So keep it in your mind, even we as a user send the data to the computer, it should be safe. Obviously, there are a lot of cell units in a RAM. So without giving a name to this memory location, how can it possible if the computer would be able to process on this data? So that's why this memory location should be given a name. Is it? So keep it in mind when we start solve a problem, we have to give the name of the memory location to the memory location, which helps us to save our data. Hope you understand that. So guys, hope you understand ke input means to get data from some input devices and store in computer memory. Our data in memory is given some particular name. That's the logic of the name. Give a name of a memory. We access data with respect to its given name to perform some computation from with results, which results are obtained. The results are stored in computer memory and we print, display the results on some output device. Look at the page number 9. The very first problem. Device to convert Celsius to 7 height temperature. Being a students, we have to ponder on the given task. Okay, it is given a task that what's our actual task? Convert what? Celsius to Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit temperature. Fine. What will be the input? Celsius or Fahrenheit. When we have the data regarding these two values, after getting the data regarding to these variable names or tasks, Celsius or Fahrenheit, after that we convert it, okay, Celsius to Fahrenheit. Celsius should be converted into Fahrenheit temperature. So basically there are two inputs. The guys, first of all, you have to understand that there are two values are required. What one of them is taken from the user and one is for the output. When we will find the Fahrenheit temperature, so we have to find the Fahrenheit after working on it. So guys, we are going to start input. What should be our input? Celsius. Celsius if we look at the problem, we see that this Celsius is not given to us by anyone. Then being a programmer, we have to think that if we have to get some values regarding to the Celsius. When we have some data about the Celsius, after getting some data, we will perform or calculate on the Celsius data. After getting this, we put some formula of finding Celsius, Fahrenheit. After that, we will find the Fahrenheit with the help of a formula. So Celsius will be our input. We are generally discuss that. Actually, to find the Fahrenheit, which will be a output.
are processing. After getting data, we need some processing. Processing, we put the formula. What is the formula of point of Celsius, Fahrenheit? Celsius multiplied by 9 divided by 5. There's a mathematically formula. Keep it in your mind. And it the formula is known by the ALU very well. The every formula which you read in your mathematics, the computer's ALU unit is constructed according to these formulas. Being a programmer, we just write the instructions for the CPU to solve a problem. We just give the instructions to the CPU. CPU already knows what is the formula, what is the calculation procedure getting calculations to find any type of formula and any formulas related results. So Celsius into 9 divided by 5 plus 32. It is already constructed in AI. After processing, obviously we will get the results. Output print Fahrenheit. Actually, this is the basic working after getting the task. And after getting the task, I totally involve in it, read it thoroughly, find what will be the output, what will be the processing, what will be the output. Okay. After that, I understand that the Celsius is the main input. We have to get the input or data from the user for the Celsius. After getting data for Celsius, we write the instructions to find the Celsius by the helping formula, which convert the Celsius into Fahrenheit. Celsius is unknown value. After getting, suppose it sends, user send us 32 or any number, it will multiply by it. After multiplying it, its answer will divided by 5. Okay, after getting the answer, it will be added into the fixed amount 32. And after adding this value into 32, we get the Fahrenheit, because it is the formula which is constructed by the mathematicians, and this formula is known very well by the ALU. Okay, and now convert it into the flowchart. Start. What will the input be? What will be the symbol? Parallelogram. Input Celsius. Okay. What will the next step? Processing. For processing, we use rectangle symbol for the processing. Every time the formula in mathematics will be called the processing statement or instruction. Processing instruction. So what will be our processing instruction?
Celsius multiplied by 9 divided by 5 plus 32. It will our processing statement for what? For finding Fahrenheit. Obviously, after calculating this formula, we get the Fahrenheit value. We use the symbol for output. Print what? What we have find? Fahrenheit. After printing, we write instructions to the end. We have finished our task. End. Hope you understand, guys. Okay, it's your task, guys. You have to find the make the flowchart regarding to the task 2, 3, 4. You have to try it at your home. The method of find the different problem 2, 3, and 4. After that, on Friday, I will discuss with you till problem 6. Hope you understand that.